morning. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing and gentlemen, remove your caps for the Pledge of Allegiance, and then please remain standing for the singing of our national anthem.
Good morning. As a senior officer of the Cocke County High School Student Council, I would like to welcome you all to the graduation of 2023. It is my honor to announce the celebration of this great day as we graduate on the threshold of our next great adventure. I give thanks to the Lord who deserves all praise and recognition because I couldn't have accomplished anything without him. Thank you, faculty and staff, for your continual endeavor to teach. And thank you to everyone who was there for support and offered a voice of wisdom.
Graduates, good morning, and welcome to the commencement ceremony for the Cocke County High School class of 2023. I would like to welcome all parents, family members, friends, school board members, Director Moore, and other distinguished guests here today in attendance. More importantly, I would like to thank you for being part of these young men and women's lives over the last 18 years. It is your love, support, encouragement and commitment to these amazing students that has allowed them to be where they are today. Graduates, congratulations. You have made it here today in the face of all the challenges that we have had to endure over the last few years. We think about the past, the present, and the future sitting here today. Think back to your freshman family night. That feeling of anxiety, fear, and even a little bit of excitement. Knowing that you were about to enter a school that had almost 1,200 students walking the halls. You may have just left an elementary school that may have had just a little over 100 students combined. Little did you know that in mid-March, you would go home for 2 weeks to flatten the curve. We all handled that difficult situation with as much grace and honor as possible. I remember spending the next 2 weeks traveling around the county, bringing homework to your homes, as well as the days of lunch pickups at school as your parents fought through the long lines of traffic. The next year, you had the opportunity during the fall semester to get a taste of virtual learning. On the days you came to school, you endured masks, temperature checks, and sometimes even quarantine. These early chapters are important ones in each and every one of your life stories. Sitting here today is a direct result of the work and effort of many people over the last 13 years of your lives. I ask that you reflect on all of your hard work, as well as the hard work of your parents, grandparents, family members, and teachers. What you want for tomorrow is reflected in the decisions you make today. In thinking of how you will move forward, I ask that you do so with a kind heart, a stout work ethic, and a positive outlook. These three simple things will allow you to move forward, thrive, and succeed in the world. Theodore Rubin wrote, "Kindness is more important than wisdom, and the recognition of this is the beginning of wisdom." This is such a powerful statement. It is important now more than ever. Lastly, I remind you of this. Never let your past be an excuse. Never let difficult situations be an excuse. Never let where you are from be an excuse. Here's some wise words to remember as you see the adult sitting before you today. A former president once said, "All those adults that used to think were in charge and knew what they were doing, it turns out they don't have all the answers. A lot of them aren't even asking the right questions. So if the world's going to get better, it's going to be up to you." I ask that you leave here today, your last day as a student and your first day as an alumnus, you always remember where you come from. Stand tall, be proud, do great things, and tell them all, "I'm from Newport, Tennessee, and I graduated from Cocke County High School." Thank you.
Let's sincerely hope that my glasses have defogged in this humidity. Many of you have noticed our graduates wearing all kinds of paraphernalia and regalia and pins and stoles and sashes and so forth. So let me take a few minutes and try to explain quite a bit of what that means and represents. Our valedictorian and salutatorian both wear medallions noting that achievement. The valedictorian's is on a black neck strap and the salutatorian's is on a red strap. Excellent gold lapel pins are worn by state honors graduates based on achieving the ACT benchmark in all four tested areas. All pins have a red stone and say state honors. Gold shield lapel pins are worn by state distinction graduates based on maintaining a 3.0 unweighted GPA and meeting one of the eight other criteria. All pins have a red stone and say state distinction. Lapel pins with the presidential seal are worn by students who receive the Presidential Education Awards by achieving a minimum of 3.5 unweighted GPA and scored in the top 15% on a national college entrance exam, for example, the ACT. The gold stoles are worn by National Beta Club members as well as our valedictorian and salutatorian. Gold tassels are worn by CCHS honor students who had achieved an unweighted GPA average of 3.0 or higher at the end of the seventh semester. Tennessee Scholar graduates wear a medallion with a red, white, and blue neck strap. A white cord is worn to designate any student who has received special recognition through College Board by being named an advanced placement scholar or an AP scholar with honor. Red, white, and blue cords have been provided by Walter State for seniors who have attained 12 hours of college credit or more through dual enrollment with their institution. A blue and gold cord has been provided by ETSU. Work ethic distinction is attained by the student applying and earning 32 points across different work-related standards, including, but not limited to, attending school, being drug-free, serving the community, etc. They are wearing white cords. CCHS has had several clubs and organizations who also reward participants with regalia, as you see on so many of our graduates. We are so proud of our community and its opportunities available for our students to broaden their horizons. Be sure to ask the graduate and your family about the significance of their regalia and their participation in extracurricular activities. Criminal justice students earning local dual credit with Walter State are wearing Hunter Green stoles. FCCLA members wear white and red cords signifying outstanding accomplishment and commitment to family, career, and community leaders of America. FFA members wear gold stoles with a blue emblem that have earned the highest degree in the State FFA Association, the State FFA degree. Students who earn dual enrollment credit in animal science wear a blue and yellow cord and have a gold charm. HOSA stoles are white with blue imprint and represents membership in HOSA Future Health Professionals. A red cord is worn to designate those students who have met the required blood donations to MEDIC of once in the fall and once in the spring of their senior year. Key Club members also wear a white cord with a gold Key Club chain recognizing good member standing. Mu Alpha Theta is a national mathematics society for high schools. Members wear a gold and light blue stole with light blue Mu Alpha Theta emblem. Big Red Fire Car seniors all wear a music medallion with a red and black ribbon and a light pink cord signifying their time as choral musicians in the Big Red Fire Choir. The choir lettermen wear a light pink stole signifying their letterman status. National Honor Society members wear a white collar stole with the national NHS insignia located on the front of the stole. NJROTC cadets who have participated for a minimum of 3 years, have obtained a 3.0 GPA, and have completed 150 hours of community service wear of white and blue stole with their NJROTC emblem. Skills USA members are noted by the white stoles with the Skills USA logo. Scholar athletes are wearing a red, black, and white cord. They have participated in sports while maintaining a 3.0 GPA. Scholars Guild members have a navy gold and white cord. And finally, the Student Council wear a royal blue cord with Student Council charm. It signifies their active involvement as a Student Council member. And yes, I'm finished. So again, on behalf of the administration, let me personally congratulate the class of 2023. I know that sometimes you may not think it, but deep down, Mrs. Brawley is extremely proud of you. With that being said, one of the disadvantages of being an administrator is that sometimes we don't get to know kids in the classroom. So unfortunately, while I never actually had Abigail Irby as a student, it is my great pleasure to introduce to her as the salutatorian. Abigail this morning will be presented with the state resolution by Jeremy Faison, signed by Governor Bill Lee, that I will present to her. I also want to comment that not only is Abigail a phenomenal student on the volleyball, or a phenomenal athlete on the volleyball court, she's also a great kid in the classroom, obviously. And most importantly, she is just a super individual that it is my honor and pleasure to introduce the 2023 Cocke County High School salutatorian, Miss Abigail Irby.
Good morning and welcome. Graduates, guests, teachers, staff, and alumni. It is an honor to be the salutatorian of the Cocke County High School graduating class of 2023. First, I would like to express my appreciation to everyone that has helped us make it to this day. To everyone in the school system, our families and friends, we thank you for all that you have done to help us get here. A special thanks to Quizlet and SparkNotes, which helped many of us graduates throughout our high school career. When I came into high school, I'm not even sure I really knew what salutatorian was, and I'm positive I didn't know it would be me when I graduated. To that point, the people that helped me get here were not focused on titles that may describe who I am, but instead on the person that I would become. I'm immensely thankful to my family who has supported and encouraged me in all my aspirations and dreams, to my friends who celebrate successes with me, and to my teachers who have always believed in my academic abilities even when I did not. Above all,
I give all the honor and glory to God for my accomplishments. Today, I congratulate my classmates of the class of 23 as we graduate from high school, making a big step towards the rest of our lives while reflecting on the memories we have made. Some of us may have known each other for many years, while others may just now realize who the person sitting next to them is because they never attended homeroom. But in the end, we are all here with a common success that we can celebrate with each other. The person next to you matters, and this may be the last time you see them. Our entire lives, it has felt like we couldn't wait for the next part of our stories. In kindergarten, all we were excited for was show and tell, and waited for the day when they would trust us with the big scissors. From middle school, we couldn't wait for high school and sitting in the student section. When we were freshmen, we looked forward to getting our license and finally being upperclassmen. As juniors, we started to think about college and our future after high school. Now, at the end of our high school career, we wished we could slow time down to reminisce on the big pep rallies for football games, all the way to our last excruciating assignment from Mr. Green. Little did we know how fast the 4 years of high school would go by. Standing here today, it would be hard to speak to each of you about collective hardships that we have faced to get to this point. We may have all sat through Zoom classes, been taken on class bathroom breaks by our teachers, and failed a test, me included, but each of us have had a unique experience pieced together by moments and challenges in our life that brought us to this place and point today. Your personal tragedy may have been losing a loved one, or possibly just failing a test. However, I hope that the challenges you faced in high school allowed each one of you to learn how to be an overcomer. Hopefully, you will be able to go on from high school, having grown from the hardships and with the tools to learn how to find joy in any situation. Speaking of joy kills, in high school, we take numerous tests. The outcomes of these tests measure our academic abilities and can label us by titles that could never fully describe who we are. No matter how you've been labeled in high school, remember that this does not define you. Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future." As my mom always says, it is just the start of the next chapter. By seeing the close of this chapter, new doors are opening for us to begin the rest of our lives. While we will always have our memories of high school, God has greater and bigger plans for each and every one of you, whether you may be joining the military, entering the workforce, going to trade school, or attending college. As we move on to the next chapter in our lives, I challenge each of you to make a positive impact wherever you go with your talents, kindness, and love. 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 12 says, "Let no one look down on your youthfulness, but rather in speech, conduct, love, faith, and purity, show yourself an example of those who believe. I'm proud of you. Your school is proud of you. Your family and friends are overjoyed for you. But first, you must acknowledge your own accomplishments and be proud of how far you have come. It has been a pleasure to experience high school with all of you. Teachers, administration, and staff of Cocke County High School, thank you for preparing us for the next chapter of our lives. One last idea that I'd like to leave with my senior class is to always be real. I'd like everyone to join me in taking a Be Real, and for those who don't know what a Be Real is, it is a two-sided candid photo. So let's be real on the count of three. 3, 2, 1. Thank you and good luck, class of 2023.
Good morning. Our valedictorian also receives a House Representative resolution from Jeremy Faison and signed by Governor Lee as well. On the stage this morning is a young lady who has overcome incredible health obstacles to be here. I don't know her very well because she's never been in the discipline office, so I sat down with her to talk about her introduction this week. She told me that she was just an ordinary student in elementary school with what she called okay grades, just A's and B's, until freshman year when she met her science teacher, Mrs. Crawford. That biology class was the hardest class our valedictorian has taken in her entire high school career. She earned an A from Mrs. Crawford, and that motivated her to excel in every other class she took from that point on. And I guess she did, because it is now my honor to introduce to you our valedictorian for the class of 2023, Miss Allie Franks.
Okay, so I'm really nervous right now. First of all, I want to start out by saying that I'm very proud of you guys. A lot of you guys may not know me, but I'm somebody who observes, and it's been a pleasure to observe you guys over the past 4 years, and I love you guys very much. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope, Jeremiah 29:11. 4 years ago, we were all getting ready to go to high school. We each had our own expectations and goals for high school. If your high school years went by anything like mine, it was not what I had expected at all. I was expecting to have a typical high school experience and do the best I could. As the years went by, they have been anything but typical. I never would have fathomed standing here today speaking to you at the beginning of my freshman year. Over the past 4 years, my life has drastically changed. From experiencing a pandemic, nearly losing my vision, babysitting full-time, and leaving the church I was at for nearly 17 years, to moving houses, my dad getting a new job, and taking nearly all classes, my college classes, my senior year. My life has drastically changed in the span of the past 4 years. Though these have not been the easiest 4 years of my life, I know that God has a greater reason than what I see for each and everything that happens. I know that a lot of you have endured things for the past 4 years that I cannot even fathom. I hope that these words I'm speaking to you today will give you hope for your future and inspire you to keep going. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope, Jeremiah 29:11. Find peace in this verse. God loves you and he has plans for you. Long ago he was thinking about you and doing things to prepare for you and your future. The hard times and good times you may be going through are a blessing because it is what the Lord has planned for you. Many of us here today struggle with anxiety and various other mental health issues. I know the feeling of being perfectly fine 1 minute to my heart beating, hands shaking, and not sure if I'm going to make it past the next moment, and to finally transitioning into the point of coming back down. In these moments of panic, sadness, or when you feel like your mind will just not let it go, remember this verse. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope, Jeremiah 29:11. Find peace in the fact that God is sovereign, and whatever is happening or will happen, there's a reason for it. God loves you. He will hold you. When you are in the deepest valley or on the highest mountain, even somewhere in between, be thankful for where you are. It will lead you to a great and indescribable place if you just put your trust in him. I want to thank God for allowing me to experience each thing that has happened, for everything he has given me. Thank you, Mom and Dad, for believing in me, leading me, trusting me, teaching me, and showing me a love that I hope I can show others. Thank you to my siblings for making me laugh, encouraging me, and always being there for me. Thank you to each and every person that has led me to this point in my life. Finally, thank you to all of my teachers, administrators, counselors, friends, classmates, and doctors who have believed in me and helped me to grow. I love you all, and I'm thankful for each and every one of you. As we enter the future, do your best in everything you do. Look to God for everything, find joy in where you are, and remember the words that God has given us. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for evil, to give you a future and a hope, Jeremiah 29:11. Thank you.
If you look at the back of your program, you will see a key to the program designations that you see beside students' names. I just want to mention the red and the black, the AP Scholars and the AP Scholars with Honors. If you are an AP Scholar or AP Scholar with Honors, please stand at this time. You may be seated. Thank you all. While many students choose the typical path after high school, such as entering the workforce, attending tech school, a college, or university, some choose a different path. They choose to commit their life to the service of their country. They either have already or will be making the following oath after graduation. I do solemnly swear that I will support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies, foreign and domestic, that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same, and that I will obey the orders of the President of the United States and the orders of the officers appointed over me, according to the regulations and of the Uniform Code of Military Justice. So help me God. With the students who have already or will be joining the military after graduation, please stand at this time. Thank you for your service and sacrifice. You may be seated and welcome to the Brotherhood. Chairman Coggins, board members, and Director Moore, by the authority vested in me by the state of Tennessee, I certify that the students graduating this morning have met the mandates for a Cocke County High School diploma. I present to you these students.
Party started, shall we? Hey, graduates, as they make their way up here, let me also say, never forget to admit your mistakes. I apologize, my AP Scholar and AP Scholars of Honors people. Please know who they are in the program. It's my pleasure to begin with the class of 2023. Miss Leah Ann Arwood with honors. Colin Askew with honors. Mr. Hunter Bailey. Sydney Grace Ball with honors. Jordan Blake Stokely. Austin Banks with honors. Braden Barnes with honors. Alexia Camille Barrett with honors. Jose Barantinos. Bailey Eric, so Baylor, I'm so sorry. Baylor Eric Baxter with honors. Elizabeth Blanchett with honors. Michaela Bolden. Sarah Amanda Bradshaw with honors. Felicity Ann Brew with honors. Damon Bricky with honors. Emily Brown. McKenna Brown. Allie Lee Nicole Buckner with honors. Madeline Buckner. Summer Buckner with honors. Tori Suprapta. Kerrigan Burgess with honors. Kaylee Butler with honors. Brennan Anthony Cagle. Sadie Carmichael with honors. Landon Carruthers. Kimberly Brianna Cash with honors. Casper Alexander Coker. Connor James Collette. Zeke Cortez with honors. Jimmy Costner. Carson Cote with honors. Aiden Coy. Dakota Crossley. Madison Cutshaw with honors. India Dale with honors. Isaac Dorsey with honors.
Carter Douglas with honors. Lainey Duncan with honors. Jayla Namaya Shanice Elliott with honors. Brianna Ellison with honors. Abigail Irby with honors. Ken Fillers with honors. Keely Fine with honors. Alex Forshaw. Hunter Caden Fox. Lakin France. Christian Jeffrey Ethan Franklin with honors. Allie Madison Franks with honors. Ashley Fundersoul. Maverick Glipsy with honors. Lance Gabriel Goines. Kobe Gorell. Ellie Marie Griffin with honors. Isaac McKinley Gudger with honors. Xander Gunn. Elijah Gunter. Hannah Josephine Gunter McLean. Macy Leanne Hale with honors. Ethan Hall with honors. Macy Malia Hall with honors. Dixie Lynn Hammonds with honors. Alicia Haney. Carolyn Irene Hannah with honors. Rayanne Hannah. Carly Danielle Haynes with honors. Michael Hembry with honors. Jasmine Lyric Henderson with honors. Isaac Henley. Andrea Michelle Herrera. David Holt. Hunter Paul Holt. JC Holt with honors.
Landon Wayne Lindsay Holt with honors. Jesse Huff with honors. Rachel Huff with honors. Skylar Allen Hull. Braden Hunt with honors. Dylan Jackson. Addison Jenkins. Kelby Jenkins. Austin Johnson. Lanny Johnson with honors. Andrea Justice. Derek Collar. Taylor. Sorry, Derek Taylor. There's always one. Samara Caitlin Kassab with honors. Yes. Braxton Kelly with honors. Brody Kinley. Jimmy Kirkpatrick with honors. Gavin Klump with honors. Ethan Gage Knight. Benjamin Kuok with honors. Carly LaForce with honors. Nicholas Lamb. Sarah Lane with honors. Elena Nicole Lewis with honors. Ethan Jameson Lewis. Madeline Rose Lewis with honors. Brody Lipton with honors. Victoria Lopez with honors. Beck Manis. Deshaun Brigg Singh Massengill with honors. Addison Massey. Madison Suzette Louise Mathis with honors. Dyson Mathis with honors. Daniel Archie James Meek. Abe Mendez. Flo Mendez. Summer Alexis Moore with honors. Shaylee Morales. Paige Niehammer with honors. Aslyn Brianna Norton.
Dixie Norton with honors. Macy Norton with honors. Billy Orsornio with honors. CC Panetta with honors. Nicholas Duke Parker. Jaron Parton. Snay Nikita Patel with honors. Arrow Braj Patel. Kayla Payne with honors. Harley Scott Perando. Hannah Annette Perrigan with honors. Gage Phillips. Gavin Pierce. Jenna Pittman with honors. Kaylee Rainbolt with honors. Ezekiel Ramos with honors. Maylee Ramos. Emily Cherie Ramsey with honors. Tia Nicole Ray. Taylor Carsey Ross with honors. Megan Lee Riley. Jonathan Michael Rivera. Sorry. Jalen Rose. Samantha Ruiz with honors. Jaylee Ruiz. Kyle Sadin. Cameron Grace Salyers with honors. Sierra Beth Sane with honors. Alyssa Hope Seal with honors. Bradley Carson Shelton. Landon Shelton. Sally Shelton with honors. Jonathan Shiflett. Marlene Ruiz. Nicholas Lester Shiflett. Alistair Shiflett. Sorry, Nicholas. Serenity Shiflett.
Emily Shropshire with honors. Evan Smelser with honors. Adeline Mackay Smith with honors. Easton Conrad Smith with honors. Hunter James Gregg Smith. Kaylee Jane Sutherland with honors. Gary Sprouse with honors. Anthony Steinbacher with honors. Victoria Steiner with honors. Brazen Jabbar Stewart with honors. Daniel Stewart with honors. Chloe Elise Stinnett with honors. Ethan Stokely. Emily Nicole Stubblefield. David Stiles. Tristan Suggs with honors. Eric Edward Sutton. Evan Sutton with honors. Terry Ray Sweet. Carlissa Tinker with honors. Destiny Torres. Alexis Trice. Huh? Ashlyn Chersnowski. Becca Kayanne Turner with honors. Jerrica Turner with honors. Carly Turner. Latrina Kathleen Upman with honors. Sabrina Marie Upman with honors. Scott Valentine with honors. Marcelo Geronimo Vargas with honors. Jody Vaughn. Jamarian Walker. Rylan Walker. Trinity Alexis Walker with honors. Isaiah Walton with honors. Isaac Weshi.
Haley Weston with honors. Alexis White with honors. Jaden Shiley White with honors. Kaylee White. Kendrick White. Medea Kaylee Sugar White. Kayla Jade Witt with honors. Tyler Williams. Nathaniel Jeremiah Wines with honors. JC Curse White Wise with honors. Major Woods with honors. Jillian Zimmerman. And Terry Lee Elizabeth Zeiser.
Hello, everyone. My name is Snape Patel. I know we all are probably getting a little restless towards the end of this graduation ceremony, so I'll keep this as short as possible. I really love this one quote by explorer Christopher Columbus. It goes, "You can never cross the ocean until you have the courage to lose sight of the shore." We all have dreams and goals of our own, whether they may be career-oriented or just personal goals. However, we'll never be able to actually achieve these goals if we stay in our comfort zones. Sometimes we try to isolate ourselves into our own little worlds, and basically, like, we try to isolate ourselves into our own little worlds and just try to avoid others and avoid all interactions. But now, as we're dipping our toes into the real world, we have to realize that stepping out of our comfort zones is the only way to actually achieve our goals and dreams. If there are hindrances in our way, we have to overcome them by embracing them head on, instead of waiting for someone else to come and remove them for us. One big idea I'll be taking away from my high school experience is, the greater the risk is, the greater the reward. Now, this doesn't exactly mean to go out there and put your life out on the line for someone or something, but it does mean that as you're walking out these doors today, I want you all to, like, start taking those small risks, and before you know it, you'll have built something beyond your dreams. Lastly, I just want to congratulate all of you graduates today for your hard work throughout these past 4 years. I know they've been rough, but I can say that we're all here today and we've made it through. Also, a special thanks to all the parents, guardians, and guests for coming to the ceremony today. Congrats, class of 2023. Let's set sail on the journey of life today.
There you go. At the close of the program, we ask that family and friends remain seated until all students have recessed and have gone to the back of the Expo Center to receive their diplomas from the counselors. And finally, class of 2023, to signify the end of one era and the beginning of another, you may move your tassels from the right to the left. Parents, family, and friends, I present to you the Cocke County High School Class of 2023.